This week, me and the Recharge ladies are going out for a meal. We decided to get together and just have a nice meal out to kind of celebrate our kind of friendships and support and all the things that we have managed to build over the last few months and even the last couple of years together. So I wanted to make a video on eating out and how this kind of impacts people and the way they feel about the food they eat, their bodies, their image, their choices, their confidence, and how eating out can either be something that makes you or it can break you. And this ultimately comes down to your mindset. So if you approach eating out, because ultimately we know that when we eat out, we probably eat a little bit more than we normally would. If we're at home, we're cooking it ourselves, we'll portion it out kind of to our own appetite level. We know the way we've cooked it, you know, what we've used, we can kind of account for it. As it were, and if we're eating out, we can't really do this as accurately. So it tends to lend itself to a little bit of stress, a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of panic when it comes to making the best choices and still staying, if you want to call it, on track in your healthy choices and your healthy lifestyle. So the biggest thing that I hear about eating out or having kind of decadent posh meals anywhere at weddings, parties, whether it's just a meal with you and your friends or whether it's a big event, is that it's kind of the gateway to falling off the wagon. And the one thing I really want you to understand about eating out is that one meal cannot make you gain a lot of weight. You know, you might just put on a tiny bit of weight because, you know, food weighs something. So when you put food in your body will weigh more. So if you're just looking at it from a weight point of view, then yes, you know, you would have gained weight in that kind of short period of time that you're eating the meal. But obviously as natural things happen, you know, as you pass it through the body, then that weight won't have gained. And if you didn't overeat during that meal and you didn't kind of overdo it, then there's no reason that food should have made you gain weight long term. Okay, so in terms of falling off the wagon, it's how you feel about your choices. It's how you approach the meal, it's how you choose to believe and how you choose to feel about the choices that you make. And then it's about how you act in the hours and days after you've had that meal. So if you have that meal and that is the gateway for you kind of falling off the wagon and feeling bad and guilty and ashamed, and then when you get home getting the ice cream out, and then when the next day you have something not so great for breakfast and then follows with lunch and dinner, and you can go into a really big spiral with this. So if you approach the meal with panic and stress and anxiety, and if you feel guilty and ashamed about your choices, and if you allow that to impact like a domino effect on the next choices that come along, then you're probably going to be stuck in this cycle for a long time. If you're not prepared to take a step back and really work on your mindset, then this kind of emotional eating, this guilty eating, this kind of ashamed feeling, this frustrated feeling, it's going to stick with you for a while. So I'm gonna kind of suggest, and I hope that you take this on board, suggest that you take a step back from it and try to think of it almost a bit more logically. So logically, like I said before, you know, unless you are literally stuffing piles of food down your throat, unless you are dramatically overeating in said meal, that meal is not going to be the thing that tips you over the edge into gaining weight. Okay, so it ultimately comes down to your choice, in that it's you can choose to think of that meal as something that you did that was bad and that you feel guilty about and that you feel ashamed about, and you know, you'll beat yourself up, you'll lose your confidence, and you know, your choices on going from there are unlikely, therefore, to be particularly good. If your confidence is low, if your guilt and your shame is high, you're more likely to go down the kind of the bad paths when it comes to the habits that we've learned and created over the years. So what I suggest is that when you know that you're eating out, one of the best things that you can do to kind of put your mind at ease is, if possible, have a look at the menu and pre-pick out the things that you think you might want to eat. Whether it's the three-course meal and you get to pick three things, whether it's starter and main, whether it's just a main, you get to choose what you eat most of the time. So If you know where you're going and you can get the menu online, which most places will do for you now, and most places will even provide you, helpfully or perhaps not, with the calorie content of the food. So I'm going to suggest that you maybe don't look at that bit, because you probably won't end up eating anything at all. But if you look at the menu and pick out something that makes you feel good about your choice while still being able to enjoy the evening, you can then plan the rest of your day around that. If you know that, for example, you're going out for a 3-course meal, that's probably more than you would normally eat in the evening. Well, it certainly is for me anyway. So I might then look earlier in the day and say, right, where can I make small tweaks to adjust what I'm doing? So rather than the kind of milky latte that you might have at the coffee shop, maybe have a peppermint tea instead, so that you can kind of redistribute those calories into the evening portion of your day. Maybe for breakfast, you normally have, you know, I don't know, 2 pieces of toast or whatever, you know, a certain number of eggs. You maybe cut that down by 1 or just decrease it slightly. So again, you can redistribute those calories later in the day. So it's a balancing act across your day, so that when it gets to the evening, you can enjoy the meal, you can have no guilt, no shame around what you ate, and you won't go home feeling like you've ruined everything, basically, because you know that you've made a plan, you planned ahead, and then you worked back from that and said, right, for breakfast, I'm still going to satisfy my appetite, but I'm not going to overdo it because I know that I want to really enjoy myself and not have to think about it later on in the day, okay? So if you can pre-plan, if you can adjust and tweak your day to really make it work for you, then you've got much more chance of being able to actually relax at your meal and ultimately teach yourself to enjoy eating out again. If it's become this big thing, if it's become this kind of stressful haze where, you know, you want this, but you don't think you're allowed to have it, and you want that, but you don't think you're allowed to have it, just bring yourself back from it all. Just try and separate yourself from it. Go and look at the menu, plan it out, make sure that you've got a sensible idea of what you want to do, and then implement the plan. That it's as simple as that. Pre-plan, implement plan. Okay, what I really want for you is that freedom of choice. I want you to feel that you can choose something that you really like and then have the confidence and the knowledge to be able to tweak the rest of your day to enable you to have this thing that you really want without kind of going overboard with the calories or overboard with the carbs or fats or protein. You know, we need that balance between all those things throughout the day so that we still continue getting the results that we want to see, because ultimately, if we're overeating or overdoing it on certain nutrients, we're going to feel lethargic. We're going to feel a bit brain foggy. We might get bloated, or we might get gas, or anything like that. And you know, the longer term side effects of overeating or eating the kind of stuff that isn't so good for us is weight gain. Okay, if we use this isolated meal as a chance to really enjoy ourselves, to really relax, and to practice this kind of sequence of things, because one thing that I know for sure is that you're going to go out for meals again, okay, and again and again and again. There's going to be weddings, parties, birthdays, events, etc., etc. There's going to be so much stuff going on in your life for the rest of your life. I want you to be able to get to that point and say, I know how to plan it, I know how to tweak it, and I literally know how to have my cake and eat it too without gaining weight and without losing confidence. Okay, I hope I've made that clear. I hope I've made it actionable so that you can go out for your meal or go out for whatever it is that you're doing and still enjoy it, feel relaxed, feel confident without feeling guilty, ashamed, and kind of stressed about the whole situation. If you are still feeling those things, please come and talk to me. I will talk you through it. I'll coach you through it. I'll help you make a plan so that you can see how it works and see how I would tweak it to make it work for you in your lifestyle. Okay, thanks for your time. I hope you have the best evening and the best weekend, and I'll see you on the next video very, very soon.